The first to call up, he plays Palutena quite differently from everybody else. A lot of people hate this character, but he gives a fresh take on her. And I definitely like to see that. One of my sons from New York, let's call up House of 3000, Jen! And his opponent, sporting one of the biggest brains in Smash. This guy keeps throwing things at you, fire hydrants, bells, ships, whatever it is. You can't get near him, and even if you do, he can still fight you off. I'm talking, of course, about DA Sinji! All right, guys, it's going to be a sick Subway Series. Two extremely talented players. You can catch them at Xeno, at all the New York locals, and the regionals beyond. Good luck to both of these guys. Aussie, Ajax, it's your turn.
Bro, is it Wednesday? I feel like we're watching Xeno right now.
I mean, we even have to put the slide up. Make sure you guys go check out Xeno's on Wednesdays. But this is definitely one of the weekly finals that we see very often between Jen and Sinji.
And these guys have fought so much. It's very similar to like the Laid versus Mars situation. Jen has the winning record here, even though technically Sinji has the better results because he's the one that's gotten like top eight, I believe it was Smash and Splash or Momocon. I forget which one it was.
He also had a couple PGRC tiers events where he had multiple top eights too. Sinji constantly taking strong Ws against many people. I think he did really well at Pound if I remember correctly too.
And he's ranked second on the New York PR, whereas Jen's at number four. Yeah. So he's also the higher player, but their head-to-head count, Jen is winning by a landslide. Jen has his number. I was talking to Jen about how he feels about Sinji. He feels 100% confident against this player. He's been playing against his Pac-Man since Smash 4 days, and it's relatively similar. He's got some new tricks, like a working grab, for instance, but it's pretty much the same way you fight him.
It was a lose button in the last game, was for real. Yeah. And the fact that that matchup is so rough, because you have the Reflector, you have the Nair to stuff out a lot of Pac-Man's best options, which are Fair and Nair out of shield. So you're going to beat it out, and it's going to get much more damage. Very stressful when you don't have to commit to going in against Pac-Man, which is what Sinji wants you to do.
Yeah, and both these players are like, they want to like make a standout performance here from New York. They both have something to prove. I remember back in the early days of Smash 4, or Smash Ultimate, I'm sorry, let's make moves. Mm-hmm. They both got top eight. And they both got the seventh, but unfortunately, that wasn't a PGR event yet because it was too soon.
Yeah, it was preseason.
And Jen did really well in like the first 2 months of the game. And then lately, he's been doing like okay.
He hasn't had the best out-of-region performances, but still consistently performs well within his own region. The consistency that he has available to him with Palutena, very strong character in terms of just keeping things simple. And, you know, he doesn't have to take as much time to build up the blueprint to success like Sinji does. Sinji wants to set you up with traps, but it doesn't matter when you have all these different things like auto reticle to stay away. And I definitely could see this going pretty long into this match right here. But the way that Jen plays, I think he's got a general idea of how he needs to work this.
Bro, can we talk about this character variety right now in top eight? I think we have eight individual different characters.
We got Bowser. We got Fox. We got Zero Suit Samus,
Lucina. Peach.
Rosalina, potentially Olimar.
Or Olimar. Then we have Palutena. Pac-Man.
Wow.
That's nine different characters.
That's amazing.
I love it.
You know, just the fact that the character diversity at the top is so strong.
Yeah.
And as the game progresses, we're seeing more and more people start to come out of nowhere with some of these characters. I mean, but Pokemon Trainer definitely not out of nowhere, but a lot more of a
popularity
rise there.
There are 77 characters in this game.
Yes.
There are 77.
We have many, many matchups. And hopefully Heroes coming at some point soon, too.
Not in time for Evo. RIP.
Yeah, but we got, and then Banjo, of course, right after that. I'm still wondering who in the world we're going to get after that.
After Banjo? Yeah. Oh, I got the leaks.
I have a couple of guesses.
I'll tell you later, man. We'll talk. We'll talk.
You get me?
Yeah, all right. Sorry, chat. All right, so we're going to jump into this next
for Smash. Set. All right, so we're going into game number one.
They're going to put in, a Battletoad. Final Destination, game one, Jen versus Sinji. Again, HO3K versus DA. There used to be a rivalry between these two crews back in the early days of Smash 4.
Hey, you still got plenty of DA that shows up every single week.
Oh,
you got
Benya,
you got Sinji, and it's being able to contest against HO3K, Ralphie, and company, and then Nick C just coming to ruin the fun.
Yeah. Nick C is, he's not even part of it. He's like NSM, but here we go. We got the, so what's going to happen is Sinji wants to get to these corners, right? He actually feels okay in these corners. Maybe not on the ledge like that with Jen putting this much pressure, but he needs some sort of room to try to set up shop. He wants to put down that hydrant. He wants to start charging his bonus fruit. You see how aggressive Jen's playing against him, not denying him access to his options.
And likewise, on the other end of that, you see that Sinji's trying to just hold the ground on the wall to look for that one mistake, like so. Because all he needed to do was get one mistech, and he brings it right back to even.
All of that off of a mistech, and it started with the forward air. That's all he needs, and now he has control. barely avoids the strawberry. Trying to go for the Nair because it's an active hitbox, really easy to two-frame with, just kind of misspaced it ever so slightly.
Pace control matchups are so difficult to do because you have to play the long game so well, and he's going to get the up smash.
There
wasn't too high. Sinji, even though he was getting hit so much at the start, kept his cool, able to close it out.
My boy Inky making a kill for him. Now, another strategy that Sinji likes to go for is when he's off stage, that's when he likes to charge his bonus fruit. So to make it safe for him, prevent the opponent from trying to get an edge trap against him, he puts the fire hydrant in the middle of the stage. What is he doing? Hey, hold on, what was that?
Using the emergency escape button in that up B there to keep himself out of harm's way.
And that's what I'm talking about. The hydrant, he puts it right there to mess up Jen's game. Because like it's hard for you to do your normal ledge trapping against someone. There's like constant water or like this trampoline like in the way. Sinji's really good at messing around with people's advantage state.
Yeah, and he's really messing with the zoning attempts on Jen too. You see he's trying to go for the explosive flame at the ledge to try and catch him slipping a little bit. But Sinji's defense has been really on point. But he's going to finally give him an opening with that back air. Yeah.
A little greedy option, tried to go for the double jump off the ledge. You're completely vulnerable, especially to a move like Palutena's back that has guard point on it.
And this is exactly what we talked about at the beginning, too. We're going to be seeing the long game strategy out of these two, because you saw all Sinji needed was one mistake, and he was able to bring it back to even. He's content with trying to catch Jen overextending a little bit at the ledge, but Jen is also content with just kind of waiting it out. It's like, look, if I'm going to get the percent lead, I'm going to run away with this.
You saw Jen get rid of that hydrant immediately, so he tried to go for the ledge trap. But then we got the Galaxian Ship combos coming in again. That was like 50 damage.
That's what makes this so difficult. Oh, and he actually ripped his jump in the midst of that, too. Now you're looking at 24% down a whole stock where you are already having trouble getting in. This is going to be pretty rough.
So when you fight Pac-Man, there's nothing else like it in this game. Like, you have to play the matchup so differently from like any other matchup. And then when you also are playing against him when he has a lead, it's like fighting Snake at that point. Like, Sinji thrives off of a lead. It's so hard to find a way in.
Exactly. The moment you have to overcommit and you have that trampoline in the way, so you have to jump by it. You can't just walk up to him and try and ledge trap him. He puts it perfectly where you can't cover anything outside of a neutral getup where he's going to meet you with a fair.
Try to throw the explosive flame in case he got a little bit overzealous with an option. Trying to push that button real quick. There we go. Dash attack uses the extending hitbox from hitting the hydrant in order to hit Pac-Man right afterwards. Avoids the Galaxian Ship. No grab. He was looking for it, though. He was thinking.
Yeah, and down tilt to give him stage positioning.
Sinji, was that a pear and orange? I need to know your answer. What is it? Tell me right now.
It's a fruit.
Oh, my God. Okay. Okay, both sides. Let's go both players.
Kiwi's going to be mad at me.
I feel it. I feel it.
All right, see Sinji rolling his way back on. Actually getting just by. Nice defense from Gen 2, not pulling the trigger early, because once Pac-Man goes into shield, he has such quick proactive moves, but going to get hit on that recovery from the Nair there, bringing it back to one stock apiece.
It's tough when Pac-Man's that low, has to go for the trampoline. Like, because the Palutena has access to that Nair, just drop down Nair is a really strong option and also a really good combo starter. He's starting to bring it back bit by bit. Already has Sinji at 37% off that one combo, and it's going to continue. Has the bell on hand as well.
Yeah, that was big damage for Jen there to start to slowly bring this back. And I like the fact he tried to air dodge right out of there, too. Not trying to get punished by Sinji.
He didn't want to try to challenge the pack jump. There could have been a potential option. What in the world?
Huh?
That was shield stun maximum 3000. Like, what?
That's cheat codes. That's
my man's got a game shark.
That's all right.
He died. He's dead.
All right.
What?
Sinji's breaking the game. Pac-Man players, I've been saying this for a long time, are actually college scientists. They are professors. They know how to break the game because that was ridiculous.
The bell killed him too. At the end, it was just the bell.
Wasn't even
the
down.
He threw out the down smash just in case. Like, he called over his boys, Pinky and Clyde, but like, he just fell.
Yeah,
so
it didn't even matter. He had no way to recover after that. And that hurts your mentality too. After taking a loss like that, you're so confused.
Was he wearing a Pac-Man shirt?
Of course he.
Look at that. I see those eyes.
Sinji reps the brand.
That's the eye emoji, the eye emote.
Also, speaking of the brand, Jen rocking the House of 3000 jersey, of course.
Oh yeah.
All right, running it back. Going back to FD, I'm very interested by this pick. We see Battlefield and PS2 both banned. A couple triplats in the company still available.
I know that Jen wouldn't want to go to Smashville against Pac-Man because that center stage like gives way too much control.
Yeah, you
Pac-Man.
Can hide under that.
But Jen
very
just
well.
Feels confident with just no platforms whatsoever. He wants to play like the straight game, you know?
Yeah, I mean, it did come down to even at the very end there, so it's not like it was out of range, and he knows he's playing the long game, but I figure maybe something along the lines of Lilat to be able to catch him on the platforms with those Nairs, make it a little more alive. I guess he wasn't feeling comfortable with it.
There we go. Nair out of shield. Just really easy option to just catch a jump. Hydrant's going to mess up with it. Yeah. gave Sinji a free recovery back onto the stage.
When you basically feel like you're playing a 2v1, the Hydra just comes in like, look, I'm just going to stop this option that you thought was going to work, and getting called out on the jump too. It's got to be frustrating for Gen dealing with it at the ledge right now.
Well, what's crazy about the Hydra is whoever has control, there we go, good stuff. Down throw, back air, reverse aerial rush, going to be able to get that kill. But what I was going to say is that the Hydra, whoever has control of that Hydra's in advantage. Because Pac-Man doesn't always own that hydrant, you know? Like, sometimes, you know, you'll see Jen who has, like, the next set. Whoever hits it first, usually the person who hits it second will send that hydrant.
Yeah, and for Jen, he has to play that key because the key, really, to being a strong Pac-Man player in general is knowing how to bait people off of stuff like that hydrant. Unless your name is E-King, who likes to use a lot of aggressive approaches, Sinji loves setting you up to think that you actually have an opportunity to punish that hydrant and take it away from him.
And Sinji's a training mode fiend. Like, he'll go there and experiment so much to try to come up with the next cool trick.
Ooh. That's what separates, you know, the average from the high-tier players. You know, when you put in that extra work, you think you have all of the layers completely figured out, and then he just throws something new at you.
I do want to talk about those pack jumps that he just did. He did a pack jump across the entirety of the stage. Because he pack jumps onto the ledge, again, that trampoline sitting there, preventing Jen from being able to set up shop with his trapping.
That's a great,
with the hydrant.
It's a great way to reset neutral, too. When you don't feel comfortable wanting to go in, I mean, he's content with going with the zoning approach right now, trying to go for the back throw up into the melon, but Jen backing off.
Okay, notice Jen actually went for the ledge right there. Gets caught point blank by the bell. Gonna see Blinky coming in. Get that forward smash. Oh, he wanted to extend that combo with the Galaxian ship. He mistimed it.
I like the reset attempt he went there for there, too. Going for two jabs, maybe seeing if he was going to spot dodge and trying to continue it. The damage would have been nice.
And he canceled the up air's landing lag after, or just like aerial lag, by jumping onto the trampoline right below it. That was really smart.
Hey, luckily for Jen, though, it seems like he's kind of gotten a grip on the way that his zoning game has been and how he's been trying to camp the ledge.
Oh, trying to pop him up for a back air. Nice
spare,
patience.
Though. That in itself is just a guessing game between the two. Like, am I going to pull it first or you? It's just a battle between the fair and the bear.
And this is where Jen feels comfortable because there's nothing in the way preventing these ledge traps.
Mm-hmm.
Get that trampoline out of here. He just up smashed the crap out of it.
Yeah,
good night. Show him the light.
That would have been great for Jen if he was able to send him at the right trajectory to land directly in that explosive flame. Didn't get it, but look at the way Jen's looking so much more confident and not worrying about Sinji sitting on the ledge so much.
He's got a lead. And it's a stock lead now at that point. I did not expect that back air to kill. I thought Sinji might have lived that.
You were preemptively calling the greater lead.
Oh, yeah, 100%. My man flew to the West Coast.
Got to get those freaking flyer miles to get on the PGR in the previous game, but not so much in this one.
So he threw the Galaxian ship against the wall. When he does that and re-grabs it, he has the ability to Z-drop with it. So that's something that's really important. Like, he does that with the key whenever it becomes like last stock.
Yeah, it's very important too, because then you get extra shield pressure. You might look for him to go for a cross up on shield to drop it, see if he pulls the trigger a little bit too early.
Yeah, the fact that he's holding on to it gives him way more access to options. There we go, just Nair out his shield. Gonna, you know, call him out for mashing with that down air. Explosive flame with his name on it. Tries to go for the trump, but good answer from Sinji. Just immediately gets back onto the stage.
And Sinji retreating back to the ledge again, but at this point, now Jen could commit to zoning. Like, he was going for the camping game too. Now I could just keep putting these explosive flames and auto reticles at the end until you feel uncomfortable. Now Bell on his target.
And he threw it against him. Sinji's just going to back up, let that build just disintegrate, because he has all the time in the world offstage.
Mm-hmm.
There's still 2 minutes and 45 seconds, so it doesn't matter that he's losing by a whole stock. He can still play as defensive as possible. Jen going super deep with that Nair. Hold on.
I heavily agree with that, too, because he's a stock up, so it's worth it. He gets the shield poke with the down air, but not going to get any kills there. And he lands directly in front of him, the KO coming in that time.
Another point blank. Hey, you know what? Whatever. Gets the explosive flame. Throw another one. Force out that air dodge.
Looking for a ledge get up option. Yeah, he's going to get himself out of dodge.
Jen is hungry for that grab. He knows a back throw will kill on the edge of the stage.
And he knows full well, too, a Galaga combo can definitely even this up relatively quickly. Does not want to deal with Sinji bringing this lead back.
Trying to space out these back airs. Trampoline put right in front of him. Might mess with him a little bit.
Another important factor for Sinji to pay attention to is as he could... Oh, never mind. Back
so
throw,
that entire situation, can we talk about that for a second? Because, like, he let go of the ledge, double jump back on there to throw a fruit, then retreated and did pack jump. If he would have re-grabbed the ledge, he would have been completely vulnerable to whatever Jen wanted to do. So instead, he opts to land on stage, hoping Jen will mess up, try to mix him up. But again, he has a lot of landing lag on stage, so he was just, the second that he messed up with that double jump Galaxian ship throw, like, it was just over.
It actually points to something I was just about to point out prior to that kill, too. As the match progressed, the higher percent, he didn't have nearly as much invincibility on the ledge. So one of those explosive flames was eventually going to pick him off. And I think that's the reason why he got up so early. He didn't want to accidentally get caught by one of those, and Jen played perfectly around it.
Yeah. But, like you say, he wanted to play really quick, but what was the nail in the coffin is he went for the aggressive option.
Exactly.
That was the thing. He let go of the ledge, he double jumped. It's one of the most unsafe options to go for. It's high risk, high reward. I get it. But here we go, going over to Unova. Now, this is an interesting counter pick from Sinji's side because, as a lot of people know, Palutena mains especially, teleports kind of get wonky on this stage.
Yeah, you get tracked on the bottom there. A lot of players seem, you know, it's a 50-50 depending on how people like this one. I'm a personal fan of it, but I get it. You know, you don't want to lose the jank like that. And yeah. Sinji, because it's open, he's going to take it. However, full hop nairs on those platforms do extend very well for Palu. So Jen will definitely make it work.
Now, noticing that, so that trampoline was right in front of Jen. He could hit that trampoline to try to disintegrate it, but as Palu, she doesn't really have, like, really quick options, like, on the ground, you know, that don't take up that much time, like a safe jab. I don't think the jab would even reach that.
Yeah, it's a good amount of end lag on that down tilt, so you try to go for that, and then Sinji can react, or just wait and take a look at what you plan to do afterwards.
So instead, Jen's just playing patient, so I appreciate that, the patience coming out from Jen.
Exactly. You have to when you're playing against Sinji. You know, playing the long game is just a part of what you're going to be walking into. I think two players that most people don't want to see on their bracket is Sinji and DaBuzz because of how well they just break down the game and make you have to come to them.
And Jen's doing a fantastic job of just, instead of breaking this wall, he's just throwing projectiles over the wall. Mm-hmm. Like, these explosive flames just keep finding their mark against Sinji. Okay, you saw DP went off because he knew Jen was looking for that back air. If he were to charge that bonus fruit a little bit too close, that he would have been dead.
Yeah, and it gives him a second to, like, recollect, too, while he's going off stage. Just like, all right, get to stall, get to try and figure out what my next move is. Meanwhile, Jen just kind of waiting for him to come back.
Very rarely will you play a character that thrives off of air dodging away from the stage. You know, like, Pac-Man's one of those characters. Wii Fit Trainer's another one. Like, there's only so many characters that benefit from an option like that.
Yeah, blessed with a multitude of good recovery options. A lot of characters would just die outright if they chose that route. But instead, the only person dying outright is Jen, gonna get killed by that up smash.
That is at least the third time I've seen Point Blank Bell kill Jen. He's gotta be on the lookout for that move. Okay, gonna block through the Galaxian Ship to avoid that big combo damage. Of course, Galaxian Ship at 0% would do so much against Jen. Mm-hmm, so I respect it.
And that's why he's had it so much when he rises off the side of the stage. He throws out the Fear, catches him with the Galaga, and then it just racks up so much damage so fast. Good defense from Sinji taking the proper route there to avoid that follow-up.
And you saw Jen throw the explosive flame on the ledge? Oh, God. Here we go. 39. Not the biggest combo I've seen from Sinji, but definitely a good one.
Yeah, and when you're facing a deficit, too, especially one that just got closed out just now by that back air.
Yeah, what deficit? What are you talking about?
I don't know.
Yeah, there we go. Explosive flame through the hydrant yet again. Usually you're going to take like two hits because the Hydra has a set amount of health. So usually it's like the two hits to get rid of that joint.
Oh, gosh. Catches the jump and he's going to get the Texas follow-up. Oh, but he's actually going to jump off the right-hand side. That would have been big damage for Sinji.
Sinji's such a sneak, dude. He would try to go for the reset on the platform. There we go. Calls him out on the roll. Next option. Does it that's the best mix-up. The no mix-up mix-up.
Exactly. You know, throwing off your opponent, just kind of confusing at him, staring at them like, wait, what are you going to do? It'll do nothing at all. And you get a read. Oh, landing directly in front.
What? Good reaction from Sinji.
This man is on fire.
You saw him tech that? He's like, wait, what's going on? Oh, I'm going to tech away. Okay, 91 looking for this bell confirm. Throws it down. Oh, gets enough shield pressure to push him away with the jab to make it safe. Mm-hmm. Smart awareness. You saw Jen just holding on to shield. Notice the shield was a little bit dwindled from being held on for so long.
Yeah, he's very much seeking out these jumps. I like what Jen did there. He chased out them right away and just air dodged right back in, a pseudo wavelength, just so he can cover the range that Sinji was trying to get him away from.
Jen tried to bait out a trump there. You saw him dash towards the stage and was hoping to make Sinji like make a quick option and punish it accordingly.
Now Sinji has to be careful because the bell is also online.
Boom! He got sick of it. He got sick of it. He's doing it to him now.
Yeah, I got my own up smash to close this out as well.
Oh my God! What? Okay, he hit the hydrant.
Yeah, he ended up hitting the hydrant, so ended up taking up away some of that knockback.
Get this bell out of here.
That move is so strong too. Oh,
the key?
That is the first key to victory that we've seen. I'm so mad I just used that reference. They would just use the key to close that out.
It's okay, Ajax. I forgive you. It's all good. All right, here we go. Get some more up airs. He barely avoided that follow-up from the dash attack. It's okay. You see him mashing buttons on that shield guy. Nair with his name on it. Continues the damage as it continues to climb. Two explosive flames in a row. Can we get a third?
Yeah, trying to force him just to go where he wants. And nice big percent lead now that Jen has. He just needs to continue to take these small trades. You don't want to consistently hit. And the frame trap right there from the up air into back air, he's just kind of running away with his lead.
Bro, does center stage even exist in this set? Because they've been playing the ledge for so long.
Exactly. You know, I mean, he's definitely been getting his real estate.
Get back over there.
Back throw might not do it just yet. Yeah, it's starting to get a little bit stale.
Send him again.
Now
there
this time
go.
He's going to get the jump with the nair, and we're going to go 2-1.
Three successful traps in a row coming out from Jen, denying Sinji any sort of wiggle room to try to mount a comeback. That's a 2-1 victory lead in favor of Jenna's best 3-of-5 set. He's on tournament game here. Sinji's got to come up with a new game plan. What worked out game one was quickly adapted by Jen.
I think this plays right into what you were talking about before. That nice big lead of victories that Jen has over Sinji is because Jen has a general idea of how to play this match. The way that he plays it slow, and he's just doing it perfectly right now.
Jen knows Sinji. Jen knows Pac-Man. Like, it's tough for Sinji to try to like mix up. That's why I like that key. You see the key, him very rarely using the key because Jen knows what to do against it. So the one time he managed to throw it out caught Jen by surprise because he's never been using it.
Exactly. You know, as the match has progressed, you got to change up your options. But now Jen looking like he's kind of, we've said it multiple times, and it just seems like he's starting to get a hold of what he needs to do to stop this.
Yeah, barely taking any damage, pushed Sinji off stage with 93 damage within the first 30 seconds. Was gambling on that roll onto the stage.
That's one of those unorthodox mix-up options. So he hasn't done that all set. And that time, he's been constantly looking for jump, looking for the roll. That Sinji, not moving though.
And that was less about getting the kill and more about sending a message.
Yeah.
That was mental damage right there. My man wanted the emotional advantage.
And if he would have gotten that too, definitely would have been walking away with quite a bit of it because Sinji would have had been looking at another stock down, looking at being sent out of this bracket.
You saw Sinji go for that dash attack. It's relatively safe for Pac-Man. Has very little cooldown afterwards. It's still punishable, but it's very tough.
Reacting to that roll with that dash attack too, mashing the up B. I think it kind of took away a little bit of knockback on him.
It's interesting that Sinji opted to go back to FD. You're going by. Good night. But yeah, it's interesting that Sinji opted to go back to Final Destination. I think this is where he got a game win. So it's like, you know what? I feel comfortable here.
Yeah.
Let's try it out. Because Unova obviously wasn't doing me justice. He's got the key. See what he's going to do with it.
And he's got to respect the fact that we talked about Reflector earlier. Hasn't really been used too much. Mm. That's another layered thing. Oh, he decides to throw it right there, trying to catch him, maybe air dodging back into stage.
Well, he saw Jenny actually fast fell into the stage to bait out something from him, whether it's the key or whatever. Just double jumped over it immediately. And you know, Jen's actually getting a lot of damage off these punishes. Yep. Anytime Sinji commits to like a charge of a bonus fruit or a throw, there's lag afterwards, and the explosive flame reaches just enough to be able to hit him before he can do anything
as
about it.
As well as when he's been trying to go get the item after he's thrown it to get the Z-drop capabilities after, he's been putting the explosive flames directly in his path. So like, I'm refusing to let you get this right now.
There we go. Tried to kick his shield a little bit. Had a nair with his name on it yet again. Throw out that hydrant. Get away from that pill.
You see, he put himself perfectly in place to try and punish him for it. Oh!
Well, Nelly.
Trying to do some extreme layers there, but
that pill went flying, dog. That flew out of the setup. Like, it's in the audience.
If that would have hit, too, that would have been huge for him because he would have finally been able to close it out. No back airs, but get to force him back off stage as well.
Okay, going for the bell again because he knows he would get a kill if that lands. Relatively safe option for him to go for as well from that distance. Okay, down throw, big damage. Oh, he read it.
He had the air dodge call, but he was just a little bit off track. He put the explosive flame in the perfect spot, but no follow-up. And he's starting to get a lot of these anti-airs too. You see that Sinji's been playing a lot out of shield now, throwing out a lot more nairs and such. He's just waiting.
Sinji is struggling right now. Again, just air dodging away to get back to stage. That's the first spot dodge we've seen from. We don't see too many spot dodges from Sinji.
Yeah, normally he kind of goes on retreat instead. So I think he's just trying to avoid some of these grabs. He's been getting a lot. He's been getting grabbed a lot more as the match progresses. Gonna get hit by the explosive flame though. Jen trying to close out the stock, and there it is.
He thought he was safe. He thought he was far enough away from that explosive flame to keep charging. Oh, and Jen, what is this?
Yeah, when Jen starts to feel himself, especially if you're not approaching, he will start to make sure that the mental damage is wearing thin. He will start to do a lot of these things.
Well, dude, this kill is starting to expire, man. Like, it's looking rotten. He's at 169%. Get him finally out of here. Back throw, give him a fresh stock.
Yeah, very much living on borrowed time right there. You know, Sinji trying to finally close it. He does. We've already seen the way Sinji's been able to close the gap on a lot of these stocks, but the thing is, being behind a full stock right now, gotta play perfectly. He's taking so much damage at the ledge.
This is looking like a wrap. I don't know what Sinji's gonna have to do to try to bring this back. He needed that Galaxian combo for one.
Yeah, that was definitely a big thing that he needed to not go away. Getting red on the roll as well. Jen looking so comfortable, just sitting back, going for the zoning approach.
Yo, he's hoping for that spot dodge. Had a backer. Right there, the trampoline, again, messing up Jens a little bit, because if Sinji would have gone for a roll, would have made it a little bit more safe. Oh, not safe Nair.
Oh,
he called out the air dodge away from the stage.
Yeah, instead of going for the back air that Sinji was definitely anticipating, he threw the explosive flame, catching him on the other end. Yeah, like you said, normally I don't like to write things off, but this is looking very, very grim for Sinji right now.
He's going to try to bring this back. No Galaxian combo with his name on it. 143. The back air, he double jumped away to try to avoid it. He went off so deep for that neutral air, gets the win, gets the kill. That's going to be Jen sending Sinji out at 7th place finish after winning 3 games in a row.
Perfect.
After losing the first one.
Perfect call right there, too. 45% full stock up, and you got Sinji who's trying to run away as deep as possible. You know what? Be willing to take that trade down there. If he goes for the side B and you get mixed up, tech it or lose the stock, but you still have him at kill percent.
Yeah, and like I said, according to the PR in New York, Sinji's number 2 and Jen is number 4.